Cryptography is the most essential branch of mathematics for keeping your bank account secure, protecting your passwords, and maintaining privacy in the digital world. But how would it look if it were turned into an RTS game? The first system I set up, and the first thing we'll cover, is the resource gathering system. Here you can see these little creatures mining, and this is set up to mimic cryptocurrency mining in a simplified format. Essentially, each of these creatures is trying to guess the solution to a puzzle, and you can see their guess appearing above their head. The terms of the puzzle are as follows. Each mining node here starts with a random string of letters and numbers, and a miner makes a guess starting with 0, and it adds 1 each time if the guess is not a correct solution. For each guess, a hash of the random string plus the guess is generated, and if the hash starts with a character 0 or 1, then it's considered to be a solution to the puzzle, and you get 10 RTS coin. The mining node then generates a new random string, and the guessing game starts again from 0. If you don't know what a hash is, it's basically a deterministic string of letters and numbers whose input cannot realistically be solved, so it wouldn't be possible to simply calculate which inputs will give a hash that starts with 0 or 1. It has some other important properties as well, but that's the basic idea. Now that we've got some money to spend, we can take a look at units in combat. Each unit has the same basic foundation, and they have different health, attack range, movement speed, and decryption speed stats. The combat system is a guessing game that is somewhat similar to the mining system. Each block of health represents a random binary string that also has a random solution. The way that the solution is found is through the XOR logical operator. XOR, or exclusive OR, operates with this logic table. So in combat, the attacker takes a string of equal length to the health bar string, XORs it with the enemy health string, continually increments it by 1, and if the result is equal to the solution for that string, the enemy loses that health bar. When multiple units are piled up on one target, the incrementing happens at a faster rate, according to their decryption speed stat. So now that we have units in combat, how does one actually win the game? Well, the ultimate goal of the game is to decrypt the secret message that is contained in the enemy base. And once it is decrypted, it becomes vulnerable to attack. The messages in each base are encrypted with a type of public key cryptography called RSA. The general idea of public key cryptography is that each user has a private and public key. If you want to send someone an encrypted message, you encrypt the message with their public key, which as the name suggests is publicly available, send it to them, and then because of math magic, they can use their private key to decrypt the message you sent. In this game, textbook RSA is used, which has a few vulnerabilities that allow for attackers to decrypt encrypted messages. It could be an entire video in itself to explain all the mathematical detail of what happens in the attack used to decrypt the message, so I'll just give a broad overview of what's happening. I've also put a link in the description to a video that goes into further detail of the attack used in this game. To start, each base displays their encrypted message, and each base has a structure called an oracle, which will try to decrypt any message given to it except for the encrypted message contained in that base. We want to decrypt the enemy ciphertext, and to do this, we will make a modified version of that ciphertext and trick the oracle into decrypting it. This means we need to encrypt our own message that contains the enemy ciphertext and send it to that oracle. If we take a closer look at the encryption process, we see that the values of the enemy's public key are used. The first thing we need to do is learn the public key values, which are located to the north. Once we capture this point and get those values, we can make an encrypted message of our own. The message is made through the following. First, we take a random integer r and encrypt it using the public key values we just got. We then multiply the enemy ciphertext with our value CR, and take that value mod n. This produces the message we need, because to the Oracle, it doesn't recognize that the enemy ciphertext is contained in the new message. We now bring the encrypted message we just created to the Oracle, and it then gives us a decrypted message, which is the secret message we want, multiplied with the value R, because decryption functionally undoes the encryption step that we just did with R. If we can isolate M by itself, then we have found the decryption of the secret message. To do this, we take the multiplicative inverse of R, and we can multiply that with our decrypted message, take it mod N, and get the final secret message, M. At this point, the shield on the enemy base drops, and the secret message can be destroyed to win the game. In terms of actual gameplay, all of the calculations of the message decryption happen under the hood, but the message that is created does actually carry a value that is used to decrypt the ciphertext in the enemy base. Because this is just a mini project, the enemy AI is very rudimentary, and there are a number of features that could improve the game that aren't present. That being said, if you'd like to give it a try, the project is free to access through a link in the description, and it can be played from within your browser. Thank you all for watching the video. Until next time.